Hey, it's Joe Glines. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate some functions I wrote for the FindText function that I reviewed earlier. And if you haven't already seen that video, please watch it because I walk through how to use the basics of the tool. This is when you launch the tool. It'll take you a little bit of practice to get used to it. So that's why that's in the other video. This one, I'm going to demonstrate some of the functions I wrote just to make it easier to click on things and to do what you want after you've found the item. So let's say I'm in a program and let's say I can't make a hotkey to, I don't know, click this, whatever. I don't even know what that button is. What I can do is I can say, okay, let me go up here and I'm going to do the same way. I need to, again, I'm not going to explain all those here. It's in the other video, but I'm basically going to tighten up on what I want to click on. A little too much, but you know what? That should be fine. I'm going to pick grayscale and I'm going to say, that's already there. Okay. And now here, just to be sure, I'll test it. And it says, oh, look, it found it. It clicks it and there it moves it up there. So, all right, that worked. Now what I've done is I've built some functions. I'm going to come in here and I'm going to highlight this, everything between the quotes. And I should have, because this is a good thing to remember. That's the comment to help me remember what in the world this thing is. And when you highlight this, it does show you what the thing is looking for. That looks like that. So now I can actually, I'm going to hide this. I'm going to bring in up my script here. And I've written some hot strings. So let's see, it's find text template. So this is what I put in between the quotes right here. So everything between the quotes, that is going to now go find that image we just, that button. And if it does, it's going to return a value to okay, which means only if it's found will this next line happen. And I'm going to say, let's say I want to left click it. So I can say, my text left click. And here are the parameters. So this is the object you pass to it, which is because that's defined here, right? It's the same thing. I should have made that the same case. Let's do that just to make it more obvious. So now when I'm on it, it shows that. And then what I built into them is if you wanted to adjust going on the X or Y axes, you can put in a positive or a negative number here, and it'll automatically move it left, right, or up and down. And then this setting is a 0, 1 if you want the mouse to move back to where it was. So let's start off by saying, actually, I'll start off by saying no so we can see it worked. So let me save this. Is it running? That's 3. Yes. Okay. I'm going to reload it. And now when I click this, so it jumped up there. It clicked that, I guess it's the overview button, right? And left my mouse there. So let me change this to a 1. And now when I click it, notice my mouse is back where it started. And so that is what this last parameter is doing. Now, when you actually use them, you can just have it like this, right? And these X and Ys, all of these, I have the default of 0, 0, and I think, I can't remember if that's a 1 or a 0 in the actual script, but they're in the functions. And let me show you. I put them, I named them find text with, and then each one, and that way I can put them in my find text script, which is in my library, and I don't have to use the include command. So move back is 0. So the default is on most of them not to move back to where it was. And let's see what else I got in here. So the overall approach is going to be the same. That's for clicking. And then let's say I wanted to right click. So find text, right click. And here this would right click on it. And again, I can get rid of all of this because those are defaults, right? And so now when I do this, it should right click, which I don't know what that'll do. Ah, look at that. So it basically kind of knew it's up in the toolbar is what it does when you right click on it. So that worked. Let me comment that out. Whoops. So I have one just to move the mouse, which obviously you don't always want to move it back, right? Because you're moving it there for a reason. But that would just move the mouse there. So there's a find text double click. I don't think double click's going to do anything on this. But again, all the parameters there, it's pretty easy to adjust. Oh, the other one, which is cool. Let me see if I can... Let's bring up Notepad. Yeah. Well, I have one. So you can send text. And the example I was doing earlier, let's say I'm in So again, this is program agnostic, right? As long as the image looks similar, and make sure you keep the resolution and text and everything the same. So I was sending a text to this. So let me go ahead and bring back this up. I'm going to capture this where it's saying search. And actually that looks pretty good. I'm going to say grayscale. I'm going to say auto and then say, okay. I'll test this just to make sure. Yeah, I found it and there it goes. And so now I am going to come in here and get everything between these quotes. Oh, I always forget to comment. So search, Facebook search. So I'm going to get everything between here. Let me go back to my script and I can hide this now. And in here, I am going to actually, I'll just do a separate one. We'll leave that one alone. Here's my template. Now I just put in that. Let me comment these out for now. And here I'm feeding it the object. I'm saying text sent, or my example. Now this one has a different parameter here of whether you want to send the enter key after you've sent the text or not. And so if it's a zero, it will not send the enter key. If it's a one, it will. Again, now here, actually this isn't a good example, but the adjust, you know, sometimes the word will be to the left and then you want the edit fields to the right. And that was the first thing I thought of with this is like, you know what, I want to easily be able to move around and not have to change the actual script. So this is, I can pass it as a parameter. So let me say I'll move back one. Yeah. All right. I'm going to save this, reload it and launch. And there it goes. And see, I had the one in there. Let me go back. The one for the enter key had it after it entered the text, it then hit enter. So I'm going to change this to a zero just to show you when I run this again. See, it dumped it in there, but notice I'm still there. I could type more if I wanted to. It's not hitting enter. So that's basically it. I mean, these are functions. I'll make them available on my website. I haven't dabbled with them too much. So like things like this might need to be adapted a little bit on depending on your Windows, on your computer and your operating system and how it's set up. Sometimes like in the functions, let me get back to the, where they are. So at the bottom here, especially on that sending text, right, where I'm sending input, which is often the most reliable, but you might try just send or send event, or even send draw, depending on what you're sending. And so this to me is, it's close enough where it should work a lot. And that's it. I hope you found this useful. Thank you.